service at the temple as well. Better spiritual master than His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada Swami.
Yeah, it's coming here.
But maybe you got cold feet. You had some second thoughts about initiation. I'm going to ask Rati to sing softly. Go ahead. Softly, Subodh. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Right ahead. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama. Thank you.
negative.
Recite Brahma Samhita together.
Ishvara Parama Krishna Satchit Ananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam Chintamani Prakara Sanmasu Kalpa Vriksha Laksha Vritesu Surabir Abhipalayantam Lakshmi Sahasra Shata Sambrahma Sevyamanam Govindamade Purusham Amaham Bhajami Venum Kanvantam Aravinda Dalaya Taksham Barhavatam Sam Asitam Buddha Sundarangam Kandarpa Koti Kamaniya Vishesha Shobham Govindamade Purusham Alola Chandra Kana Sadvana Malya Vamshi Ratnangadam Pranaya Kenika Lavilasam Shamam Tribangalanitam Niyata Prakasham Govindamani Purusham Amaham Bhajami Angani Yasya Sakalendriya Vrittimanti Ashanti Panti Kalayanti Chiram Jaganti Ananda Chinmaya Sat Ujwala Vigrahasya Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Advaitam Achutam Anadim Anantarupam Adyam Purana Purusham Navayovanam Cha Vedesha Durlabham Adurlabham Atma Bhakto Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Pantastu Koti Shatabhatsara Sampragamyo Vayoratapi Manasomuni Pungavanam Sopyastiyat Prapadasinya Vachincha Tatve Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Eko Yaso Rachayatam Jagadanda Kotim Yach Chaktir Asti Jagadanda Chayaya Dantaha Andantarasta Paramanu Chayantarastam Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Yad Bhava Bhava Tadiyomana Jasta Taiva Samprapya Rupa Mahimashanayana Bhushaha Suktairya Eva Nigama Pratatai Stuvanti Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Ananda Chinmaya Rasapati Bhavitamis Tabirya Eva Nijarupataya Kalabihi Govamoka Eva Namisatya Kiladma Bhuto Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Premanjana Charita Bhakti Vilochanena Santaksa Daiva Hridayeshu Vilokayanti Yam Shama Sundaram Achincha Gunaswarupam Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Ramadi Murtushukalani Amena Tishtan Nanavataram Akarod Bhuvaneshu Kinto Krishna Svayam Samabhavak Paramak Pumanyo Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Yasya Prabha Prabhavato Jagadanda Koti Koti Shvashesha Vasudhani Vibhuti Bhinnam Tad Brahma Nishkalam Anantam Ashesha Bhutam Govindamadi Purusham Amaham Bhajami Maya hi yasya jagadanda shatani sute Trigunya tat vishaya veda vitaya mana Sattva valambi parasattvam vishuddha sattvam Govindamadi purusham hamaham bhajami Ananda chinraya rasamataya manakso Yat praninam paliphalam smaratam upetya Lilayatena bhuvanani jagatya jasram Govindamadi purusham hamaham bhajami Goloka namni nijadamni tale chatasya Devi maheshu haridama suteshu teshu Tete prabhava nichayavi hitaschayena Govindamadi purusham hamaham bhajami Shrishti stiti pralaya sadhana shaktireka Chayeva yasya bhuvanani vibharti durga Ichyam-urupam-abhiyasya-chateshta-tesam Amaham bhajami Deeparshadeva hitashampanam apyupetya Deepayateva vritahetu samana dharma Yaspradrageva hitashavishnutaya vibhati Govindamadi pudusham Amaham bhajami Yakaranarna vajaleva jatisma yoga Nidramananta jagananda saroma kupaha Adara saktim avalamya param svamurtim Govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami Yas yaika nishvasita akalam atavalambhya Jivanti loma vilaja jagananda nataha Vishnur mahansi hayasya kalavishesho Govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami Vasvanyatakshma sakaleshu nujeshu teja Sviyam kiyad prakariyad tadvitadvadatra Brahmaya esha jagadanda vidhana karta Govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami Yatpada pallava yugam vinidhaya kumbha Dvandve pranama samaye saganadi rajaha Vighan vanhantam alabhasya jagatrayasya Govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami Agnir mahiga gandrum ambu murudishascha Kalastatadma manasita jagatrayani Yasmad bhavanti vibhavanti vishanti yancha Govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami Yachchakshir esha savita sakala grahanam Raja samasta suramurtir ashesha tejaha Yas yagya yabramati samrita kala chakro Govindamadi purusham tamaham bhajami Dharmata papa nichaya shrutayasta pansi Brahmadi kita patagavadayascha jivaha Yadratramakra-prakata-prabhava Govindamadi-purusham-tamaham-bhajami Yastvindra-gopam-atavindram-ahosva-karma Bhandhanurupa-palabhajanam-atunoti Karmani-nirdahitukintu-cha-bhakti-bhajam Govindamadi-purusham-tamaham-bhajami Yam krodha kama sahaja pranayadi bhiti Vatsalya moha gura gaurava sevya bhavai Sanchinchitasa sadrishim tanam apurete Govindamadi Purusham Shriya Kanta Kanta Parama Purusha Kalpa Taravo Druma Pumish Chintamani Kana Mai Toyam Amritam Gata Ganam Natyam Ganamam Api Vangshi Priyasaki Chidanandam Jyoti Param Apitat Asvadyam Apicha Sa Yatra Kshirabhi Shabati Surabhi Vyascha Sumahan Nimesha Dhyakyo Vavrajati Nahi Yatrapi Samaya Bhaje Shveta Dvipam Tamaham Iha Goloka Mityam Vidantaste Santashiti Virala Chara Katipaye Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachit Ananda Vigraha Adir Adir Govinda Sarvakarana Karanam. Going to read a verse and purport from Bhagavad Gita, chapter 7, text number 19. Bahunam jamanam ante jnanavan mam prapadyate vasudeva sarvamiti samahatma sudurlabha. Translation: after many births and deaths, he who is actually in knowledge surrenders unto me, knowing me to be the cause of all causes and all that is. Such a great soul is very rare. And Srila Prabhupada's purport. The living entity, while executing devotional service or transcendental rituals, after many, many births, may actually become situated in transcendental pure knowledge that the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the ultimate goal of spiritual realization. In the beginning of spiritual realization, while one is trying to give up one's attachment to materialism, there is some leaning towards impersonalism. But when one is further advanced, he can understand that there are activities in the spiritual life and that these activities constitute devotional service. Realizing this, he becomes attached to the Supreme Personality of Godhead and surrenders to him. At such a time, one can understand that Lord Sri Krishna's mercy is everything, and that he is the cause of all causes, and that this material manifestation is not independent from him. He realizes the material world to be a perverted reflection of the spiritual variegatedness, and realizes that in everything there is a relationship with the Supreme Lord Krishna. Thus he thinks of everything in relation to Vasudeva or Sri Krishna. Such a universal vision of Vasudeva precipitates one's full surrender to the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna as the highest goal. Such surrendered great souls are very rare. And it continues with Shvetashvatara Upanishad and Chandogya Upanishad references. Similarly, Lord Vasudeva, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Sri Krishna, is the prime entity in everything. In this body, there are powers of speaking, of seeing, of hearing, of mental activities, etc. But these are not important if not related to the Supreme Lord. And, last sentence, because Vasudeva is all-pervading, and everything is Vasudeva, the devotee surrenders in full knowledge. With further references, Bhagavad Gita 7.17 and 40. Initiation is a process of surrender. Submission, and because it's a relationship, it's a simultaneous acceptance of that submission from the personality of Godhead, and that submission is appropriately done through the disciplic succession, through the representatives of Krishna. Prabhupada gives this nice example. Supposing there's an ambassador of some country, and the ambassador goes to a foreign country, and in that foreign country, they offer some gift. Now, who does that gift belong to? A, the ambassador, or B, the country? Real easy. If the ambassador thinks, oh, it's mine, he can be put in jail. He's the thief. It's meant for the country. As the representative of the country, the ambassador of that country, it's not his. So, similarly, in the process of initiation, there's submission unto the preceptor or the Diksha Guru, but that submission is meant for Krishna. And similarly, the acceptance is from Krishna. Now, there may be acceptance of the gift by the ambassador. Oh, thank you very much. In fact, here's some gifts for you. These are cultural things, you know, statesmanship, but cultural things that are included in worldly affairs. And in transcendental affairs, similarly, the acceptance. And within the culture of Krishna and Krishna's representatives, there are, according to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, there are things that are given. A name is given, neck beads are given, tilak marking is given. Traditionally, with the Brahminical initiation of an individual, a deity that one may worship is given. And a branding, you know, the mark of Vishnu on the shoulders. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains, for Lord Chaitanya was very merciful. He didn't require the branding program. But he, rather it was tapa. And tapa, he indicates, for followers of Lord Chaitanya, is the tapa of regret, of having wasted whatever the previous time in this lifetime and countless numbers of previous lifetimes, and with that, the impressions that go with those that misdirected free will choices, and the impressions that come from that in the mind, and cluttering the heart. So that tapa, or that regret for a Vaishnava, is purifying. Not lamentation, but regret. So that one can clear the way to move further to the light, or to the submission unto Krishna, recognizing that Krishna is very kind and Krishna's acceptance is there. So this verse in Bhagavad Gita, Bahunam Janmanam Ante Gyanavan Mam prapadyate. How does this begin? How does one come to that jnanavan? It's not simply many, many births. You count up the number of births and then the bell rings. You're jnanavan. You've learned your lessons because you've had enough births. That's not how it works. In Krishna's instructions to Uddhava in Srimad Bhagavatam, there's a very nice verse which indicates how that happens. Chapter 20. The chapter is pure devotional service. Here's what Krishna says to Uddhava. Yadrichchaya mat katadao jata shradhas tu ya puman na nirvino nasti sakto bhakti yogo sya siddhidha. I wanted to emphasize specifically this word yadrichchaya. It appears here and there within the Vedas. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, not specific to this verse, but in general, in Madhurya Kandambani is one example, is what's the determining factor for a devotee to give bhakti, because the devotee has bhakti, a bhakta, to give bhakti to someone else? What's the determining factor? And he says, yadrichchaya. It's inexplicable. Prabhupada's rendering of that is causeless mercy. What's the cause of the causeless mercy? It's causeless. Yadrichchaya, somehow or other. That same term is used, you know, for those of you that get asked, how does the jiva fall? Yadrichchaya. Somehow or other. Well, wait a minute, it doesn't make sense. It's so nice in the spiritual world. Why would we leave the spiritual world? Yadrichchaya. We can say misuse of free will. Okay, what's the cause of the misuse of the free will? Yadrichchaya. There's no good reason. It's a free will choice, but there's no good reason for it. There's a bad reason for it, but no good reason for it. It's inexplicable. Nirvachaniya, another term. You can't speak it. Vacha. Nirvachaniya. It can't be spoken. Well, wait a minute. Because we're accustomed to cause and effect. So here's Sankirtan devotee. And the Sankirtan devotee has the mission of giving the holy name or giving literature or the opportunity to contact devotional service. And there's this sea of people out there. What prompts the devotee to go to this person instead of that person or another person? Yadrichchaya. You know, sometimes it's known, anyways, devotees will go approach younger people because maybe younger people are more like open and flexible. And I was just reading some Sankirtan stories where someone from Toronto was in New Zealand. And they found just the opposite. You know, the young people were aloof and the older people were interested. You can't judge a book by its cover. There was a period of time when a devotee, a godbrother named Preraka, and I would go distribute books together. And it was so much fun. We would stand together and look at the people that were passing by and try to pick the most unlikely person. So there, you distribute a book to them, and then you distribute a book to them. And then we'd laugh and go distribute the book to them. Most unlikely people. And then, you know, it was exhilarating and like spiritually intoxicating. And we just spent the whole day doing that. Most unlikely people. Because it's not based on, you know, this yadrichchaya. It's causeless. Or it's the potency of the personality of Godhead is what makes it happen. It's not something else. So unlikely becomes possible because of descending mercy. So here's the translation of that verse, yadrichchaya mat katadao. If somehow or other, by good fortune, one develops faith in hearing and chanting my glory, such a person, being neither very disgusted with nor attached to material life, should achieve perfection through the path of loving devotion to me. I'll read a bit of the purport. If somehow or other one gets the association of pure devotees of the Lord and hears from them of the transcendental message of Lord Krishna, then one has the chance to become a devotee of the Lord. As mentioned in the previous verse, those who become disgusted with material life take to impersonal philosophical speculation, very similar to what Prabhupada wrote in his Bhagavad Gita purport, and rigorously try to stamp out any trace of personal existence. Those who are still attached to material sense gratification try to purify themselves by offering the fruits of their ordinary activities to the Supreme. A first-class candidate for pure devotional service, on the other hand, is neither completely disgusted with nor attached to material life. He does not desire to pursue ordinary material existence any further, because it cannot award real happiness. Nevertheless, a candidate for devotional service does not give up all hope for perfecting personal existence. A person who avoids these two extremes of material attachment and impersonal reaction to material attachment, and who somehow or other gets the association of pure devotees, faithfully hearing their message, is a good candidate for going back home, back to Godhead, as described here by the Lord. That's the verse specifically is describing somehow one becomes attached to hearing the messages. That's a mature stage, attached. And there's, you know, before attached is some attraction, and before attraction is some regulation. And before that regulation, there's some association. This yadrichchaya is operating at every step. There's still some free will choices. Just like a book distributor may approach somebody and they say no, and somebody else says yes. So in that dynamic of somehow or other, causeless mercy going here or going there, there's still submission. So both the descending mercy and the accepting of that descending mercy, progressing over a period of time, may come to this stage. An initiation is where there's acknowledgement of the candidates for initiation that they're very sincere. I sat in on a lecture, attended a lecture where Prabhupada was speaking about It wasn't an initiation lecture, it was just a general lecture, and he was describing, you know, a room full of people, saying initiation is for people who are sincere. Then he said, there's the opportunity for everyone to hear. And after hearing, some may continue to hear, some may go away. And it was like explicit, Prabhupada was saying to the people in the audience, I know many of you aren't going to be here for long. Then he went on and said, but that's okay because there's permanent benefit, permanent asset that comes into the life of someone who even once just hears the holy name or hears the message of Krishna. There's no loss. Everyone can be engaged in that process. But initiation is for those who are sincere and serious. They want to continue. They do continue, and they want to continue further in the journey back to Krishna. So that's sustained submission, application of the hearing process, and the application of the hearing process means that it's applied in life. I live my life according to those messages that I have heard. Sevaya, tadvidhi, pranipatena, pariprashnena, sevaya, upadikshanti te jnanam, jnaninas tatpadarshanaha. As we've been discussing, with faith, it certainly takes faith to carry on in devotional service. Not blind faith, but certainly faith where there's hearing the message, then the message enters and one is requested or instructed in scripture to carefully consider. Not just blindly accept, but carefully consider. And if there's some question about, how to properly understand this or that, how does this fit with that? And like Arjuna does in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna, before you said this, and now you're saying that. I'm confused. It seems contradictory. Can you clarify? Those kinds of inquiries are encouraged. So it's not blind acceptance, it's thoughtful acceptance. But I distinctly recall Prabhupada saying this on more than one occasion. That's appropriate, that kind of, how do these things fit together is appropriate prior to initiation, and after initiation it's not so appropriate. In other words, not that inquisitive spirit has to be switched to the off position, but those seeking clarification on how does all of this work, sambandh again should be clearly in place, so that as one then goes further into the abhidhaya again, the applying those teachings in a systematic way and a structured way and an organized way and under guidance and carrying forward and further. I'm reminded of a little an episode with one of the first times. Prabhupada had us go to Mayapur, or invited the devotees to come to Mayapur, and what you see now is not what it was like in 1974. It was just open agricultural fields. The what we called at that time the long building that's now the Lotus building. It was just out in the middle of a field. And the temple was the other building that was there. And that's the Conch building. Conch building. Yeah, Conch building. It's just those two buildings standing in the middle of agricultural fields. And any you look in any direction, it was just agricultural fields, except, you know, a little bit developed along Bhaktisiddhanta Road. And so one day we were, the program for the festival that we were participating in was led by Achyutananda. And I don't know if you've ever heard any of his kirtans, but he was like really skilled in singing and mridanga playing. And so he just led us off and, you know, along the agricultural fields, going, you know, just endlessly kirtan through the fields of Mayapur. It was very nice. And then we came to one place. When you go there today, you won't see what we saw then. It was the Kolavachar Sridhar's place, or where he resided. Now that's, you know, in the back area behind Jagannath Mandir. But then it was just agricultural fields. And off in the middle of the agricultural field was a little stamba, like, you know, like this table, about that tall. And then on top was a little kind of a box. It was stone, a column, and then on top was kind of like a wooden box. So we stopped there. He knew where it was. We just, you know, in the middle of agricultural fields and started. So we all sat down because he was going to give some katha about Kolavachar Sridhar and the significance of the place and the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya with Kolavachar Sridhar. You know, Hari Katha. And off from a distance, one man saw all these potential donors for his little shrine there. And he came out and, you know, opened the door and started clanging his bell and waving his incense right in the middle of the katha. And Achyutananda said, "This is a classic example of Kanishta Adhikari. They understand this is the Lord, and the Lord is in the temple. They don't have any sense of the value of Hari Kirtan and Hari Katha. Both have their place, but it's you know, those who have the sense of Kanishta, well, this is insignificant. It's like we don't even exist. It's, you know, there's one thing, that's the deity. You go to the temple to see the deity, you say your prayers, you put something in the hundi box, and off you go. It, you know, those of the brahmacharis that live in the temple see it all the time. They don't want to hear anything. You give them some little prasad in the back, and that's fine, but, you know, that's Kanishta. There's not appreciation for the process of devotional service beyond that, and, you know, acknowledging the exactly as it teaches in scripture. You know, the devotees and honoring the devotees and different positions of elevated devotees and, you know, the madhyama. You know, the peer devotees and the less fortunate and giving mercy to the less fortunate. It's just, you know, the deity, like in a church or a temple or a synagogue or a mosque. You go to the place and you offer your prayers and off you go. God is there. God is there. And that's all I know. That's the Kanishta mentality. So very kindly, Prabhupada introduced all of us pronto, like from the get-go, in the next stage beyond the Kanishta to the Madhyama stage, based on hearing and chanting. And based on hearing and chanting, his statement was, where there is life, then life attracts life. In places that were previously churches that had then become empty, many of our initial Hare Krishna temples were churches that had become empty. And now they're, Prabhupada's statement, now they're filled. Or, you know, daily, regularly, people would come for morning, evening, because why? Because there's life. And so in the temple, there should be life. Not, you know, certainly worship of the deity done nicely, but the life of Hari Katha, Krishna Katha. And one who has faith in that, that's what this Krishna is teaching to Uddhava, somehow or another, if one develops faith in that, that somehow or other is the extending of compassion, the extending of the opportunity for hearing and chanting to those who can somehow or another say yes by their free will choice. And by that combination, one can come to this stage where it's the submission, the saying yes, and offering one's submission unto Krishna in the form of this Hari Katha and the deity and the serving of the devotees and the Sankirtan. Formal submission unto Krishna, acceptance. That's the significance of initiation. So I don't know if everybody in the room is aware. These two devotees, they're from the Dallas Temple, and their introduction to Krishna consciousness was through their kind brother, or his kind brother. Who's the older brother, by the way? You're the older brother. Shankadari is the older brother. Could you say a little bit, some few words, of, we have a microphone, of, over there, Shankadari, raise your hand. Huh?
We have a recording from Nityananda Prabhu.
Okay, but you speak something. About, you know, some appreciation for your younger brother.
Okay, Maharaj.
This is spontaneous, by the way. It's not at all rehearsed.
So, when we came into Krishna consciousness in 2005 or so, so he was attracted to what we were doing, Maharaj. It's nothing I preached anything to him, but he was attracted to the practices that we are doing, starting with hearing and chanting. And he himself started chanting, and then he inquired further, and he, you know, upon his own interest, he practiced. And same way, he gave it to his wife, and also both were interested, and they've been chanting 16 rounds and regularly hearing, very attracted to hearing and chanting. And then they moved into different places all over the US, and they saw the devotees, associated with various devotees, and most recently they are in Dallas and they're serving there. So, and by your mercy, you gave them the shelter. And
well, specifically in relation to Nityananda, say that part. Speak into the microphone, by the way. They're the host of what? Bhakti Vriksha program?
Yeah.
Can you explain about it a little bit?
So, sure. after they moved to Dallas, Nityananda Prabhu was kind enough to engage them in hosting Bhakti Vriksha regularly in their home, and they are participating in services in the temple, and that way he's engaging them in devotional service.
Yeah. Nityananda is the temple president in Dallas. He not only, their home is the host of the Bhakti Vriksha program, but the person who speaks at that Bhakti Vriksha program is
Nityananda Prabhu.
Nityananda. And I invited Nityananda to make a little recording of some words of appreciation, and now we're going to hear that, I hope. Is it live or recording?
Recorded.
So I'm very happy to introduce two very wonderful devotees from Dallas, Narendra and Manjari. And they have two wonderful children, Akshay and Tejaswini. The family moved to Dallas in 2012, very early on in 2012. Within a month or so of moving to Dallas, started the Bhakti Bhiksha program, which I personally attended a number of times. And I'm very proud to say that both these devotees are very nice devotees, very sincere, dedicated devotees, who serve at the temple as well, with dressing of Srila Prabhupada, helping with the kitchen and other cooking services. So I am really proud now that they're taking initiation, and that they're taking initiation from us, and they couldn't have asked for a better spiritual master than His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada Swami Maharaj. We're very happy that they take initiation. We look forward to seeing them back in Dallas and having our community become a better community as a result of this wonderful event. Thank you very much. All glories to Srila Prabhupada Swami Maharaj and glories to Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna.
Have you heard this recording before? Huh? You heard. What's it like hearing your glorification over a loudspeaker? Have a little discussion with Sri Vrindavan about it.
Oh, no.
But I know that Nityananda Prabhu has special affection for both of you. He's mentioned this on a number of occasions, and it's not cosmetic, it's very genuine. And so we're happy to welcome both of you in Krishna's family. So you come forward, both of you, and offer obeisances to Prabhupada, take your vows. Come here, play bass and sister. Okay. Yeah, sitting here right here is good. Very good. So how many rounds you'll chant every day? Okay. And the rules that you'll follow? Okay. And for the rest of your life, you'll very carefully make your best effort to follow Srila Prabhupada's teachings. Yes? Very good. Your initiated name is
Natabhara Das.
Natabhara Das Prabhu Ki.
That name, Natambara, can mean different things depending on whether you're a Vaishnava or a Shaivite. But we know that Krishna is the source of everything. Prabhupada spoke in a public assembly in 1972, saying, that's how we began, Natambara. Means the greatest dramatic dancer, and I want to speak today, greatest dramatic dancer. Watch him dance. So, Natabhara Das, servant of Krishna. Okay, so how many rounds you'll chant every day? Okay. And the rules that you'll follow? Like your good husband, you'll very carefully follow Srila Prabhupada's teachings for the balance of your life. Very good. Your initiated name is now Prema Manjari Dasi.
Prema Manjari Devi Dasi Ki Jai.
Prema Manjari in Kavi Karnapur. You can look this up later. Kavi Karnapur writes in the amongst the associates of Radha and Krishna. Prema Manjari is one of the principal associates of Radharani, one of her dear most friends. Several times he mentions like that. And have you ever been to Vrindavan? No? One day when you go to Vrindavan, you'll go to the Radha Damodar temple, and you see the little rooms where Prabhupada began writing his Srimad Bhagavatam. And then you'll go into the courtyard and you'll see the, well, it used to be very nice, now it's something else, but the Bhajan Kutir and the Samadhi of Rupa Goswami. And then way over to the right-hand side, as you're facing the deities, the right-hand side, there's a Samadhi of Bhugarbha Goswami. Or Bhugarbha Thakur. These two, Bhugarbha and Lokanath, they went to Vrindavan before Lord Chaitanya took sannyas. They were dear associates of Lord Chaitanya. And Bhugarbha Goswami, according to Kavi Karnapur, is the same Prema Manjari, dear associate of Srimati Radharani. So when you're circumambulating, you can think of Bhugarbha Goswami as your same, as your namesake, Prema Manjari.
So now when we do the yajna, whenever we say swaha, you'll use those grains with these three fingers and put into the fire. Keep your beads aside so you can give it to someone. No? Okay? That's right. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Romapada Swamin Itinamine Swaha Swaha Swaha
Om Ajnana Tamarandasya
Om Ajnana Tamarandasya
Yananjana Sanakaya Chakshurun Militam Dhyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Saha 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 Shri Chaitanya Mano Bhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Svayam Rupagata Mayam Dadati Svapadantikam Svaha 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 Mandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam
Shri Rupam Sagrajatam
Sahagana Raghunatham
Sahagana Raghunatham
Anvitam Tam Sajivam
Anvitam Tam Sajivam
Sadvaitam Savadutam
Sadvaitam Savadutam
Parijana Sahitam
Parijana Sahitam
Krishna Chaitanya Devam
Krishna Chaitanya Devam
Shri Radha Krishna Padam
Shri Radha Krishna Padam
Sahagana Lalita
Sahagana Lalita
Shri Vishakanvitamscha
Swaha
Swaha Swaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya
Nama Om Vishnu Padaya
Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Namaste Saraswate Devi.
Namaste Saraswate Devi.
Gauravani Pracharine.
Gauravani Pracharine.
Nirvishesha Shunyavadi.
Nirvishesha Shunyavadi.
Paschatya Deshatharine.
Paschatya Deshatharine.
Swaha. 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 Nama Om Vishnu Padaya. Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale. Shrimate Bhakti Siddhanta. Saraswati Iti Namine. Shivarshabhanavi
Devi.
Dayataya Kripabdaye. Krishna Sambandha Vijnana. Dhyane Prabhave Namaha. Madhurya Ujjvala Premadya.
Madhurya Ujjvala Premadya.
Shri Rupa Nuga Bhaktida. Shri Gaura Karuna Shakti. Vigrahaya Namostute. Namaste Gauravani. Shri Murtaye Dinatarine. Shri Rupanuga Virudha. Apasiddhanta Dvanta Harine. Swaha. 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 Namo Gaura Kishoraya.
Namo Gaura Kishoraya.
Sakshad Vairagya Murtaye. Vipralambarasam Bodhe.
Vipralambarasam Bodhe.
Padam Bhojaya Te Namaha. Swaha. 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 Namo Bhakti Vinodaya.
Namo Bhakti Vinodaya.
Satchit Ananda Namine.
Satchit Ananda Namine.
Gaura Shakti Sarupaya.
Gaura Shakti Sarupaya.
Rupanugavarayate. Swaha. 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 Gauravir Bhava Bhumestvam. Nirdeshta Sajjana Priyaha. Vaishnava Sarva Bhama. Sri Jagannathaya Te Namaha. Swaha. 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 Vancha Kalpaturubhyascha. Kripa Sindho Vya Eva Cha. Patitanam Pavane Pyo. Vaishnave Pyo Namo Namaha. Swaha. 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 Namo Mahavadanyaya. Krishna Prema Pradayate.
Krishna Prema Pradayate.
Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya.
Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya.
Namne Gurutvishe Namaha. Swaha. 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 Panchatat Patmakam Krishnam. Bhakta Rupa Swarupakam. Bhaktavataram Bhaktakyam. Namami Bhakta Shaktikam. Swaha. 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 E Krishna Karuna Sindho. Dina Bandho Jagatpate. Gopesha Gopika Kanta.
Gopesha Gopika Kanta.
Radha Kanta Namostute. Swaha, Swaha, Swaha. Jayatam Surato Pangor.
Jayatam Surato Pangor.
Mama Manda Mater Gati. Matsarvasva Padam Bhojo. Radha Madana Mohano. Swaha, Swaha, Swaha. Divyad Vindaranya. Kalpa Drumadaha. Srimad Ratnagara. Singhasanasto. Srimad Radha. Sri Lagovinda Devo. Prishtalibhi. Sevyamano Smarami. Swaha. 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 Sriman Rasa Rasarambhi.
Sriman Rasa Rasarambhi.
Vangshivata Tatastitaha.
Vangshivata Tatastitaha.
Karshan Venusvanayar Gopir.
Karshan Venusvanayar Gopir.
Gopinatha Shriyestunaha. Swaha. 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 Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi.
Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi.
Radhe Vrindavaneshwari.
Radhe Vrindavaneshwari.
Rishabhanu Sute Devi.
Rishabhanu Sute Devi.
Pranamami Hari Priye. Swaha. 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 Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Prabhu Nityananda. Shri Advaita Gadadha. Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Swaha. 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 Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare
Rama, Hare Rama.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama.
Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Rama Rama, Hare
Swaha.
Swaha.
Swaha. Final mantra standing, please. Take your bananas with you when you stand. You show them.
Yeah, please stand with banana in both the heads. Can you take that bead?
Namo Brahmanya Devaya.
Namo Brahmanya Devaya.
Go Brahmana Hittaya Cha. Jagat Hitaya
Krishnaya.
Govindaya Namo Namaha. Swaha. Swaha. Swaha.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.